Hey Boxstormers, this video is going to talk about items. Because when you think about it, no matter how big or small your business, you need to be able to track your items. The purpose of this particular video is to provide a quick overview of adding items into Boxstorm. But for the sections we don't cover, we have additional training videos that focus on them. Alright, let's do this. This right here is the item module, and items are the key to Boxstorm. Setting up items correctly will ensure that Boxstorm tracks your items properly from the get-go. So, let's get this right. First, we go over here to this new button at the top right. This first page is where you will name your new part or item. I'm going to add a new item and name it Hybrid Mountain Bike. And then I'm going to add a brief description. Now, I have Hybrid Mountain Bike as an item in my inventory. Simple enough, but specific names make a big difference here. The names for each item in Boxstorm need to be unique so we don't create any confusion from part to part. And we cannot have an item with the same name as a part that is already in the system. It just won't allow it. Additionally, adding descriptions to each part will help eliminate any confusion about that part or item. So make sure to include important details about that item. It's kind of like when you only have one kid, it's easy to remember their name, but when you get to like kid 9 or 10, you start to lose track. I mean, having 10 kids is normal, right? So, moral of the story, don't name two of your kids Matt. Just trust me. Now let's take a moment to go into our inventory. There are three different types of inventory in Boxstorm: standard type, service type, and shipping type. Standard type inventory will track how much inventory you have on hand and where it is located. I mean, this is your stuff. Service type is used for items that you're including on the invoice to charge customers. For example, this would be your service fees, assembly fees, or repair fees. And shipping type, spoiler alert, is for shipping items. This gives you the ability to charge customers for shipping if you are using the invoice features inside Boxstorm. Now, we have other fields in this item pop-up that we won't cover here, but they are covered in other training videos. So if you have a question or issue with one of the fields, find those videos listed under the new item category. So that's the basics of how items work in Boxstorm. It's very intuitive and to the point. Just remember, make sure each item added is given a unique name and you'll save yourself a big headache down the road. That's it, folks. So keep checking out these other videos, and together we are going to become Boxstorm pros.